basically people are preoccupied by Brexit and they're worried about what it means for their individual farm, their individual businesses. They're hoping to get some answers, a little bit of clarity, but I think a lot of them know they're going to have to wait until after Parliament votes on the agreement.
I mean, I think that we have to be realistic. I think that the only deal will be one based around some form of customs union arrangement with the EU and also some alignment of the single market.
We're 12 weeks away from supposedly leaving the European Union. Nobody's got a clue how that's going to pan out, even the Minister in charge of agriculture, food and the environment. And that's a concern. It's a massive concern and a massive worry. And this sort of all right on the night syndrome feels increasingly fragile.
I think it's a unique opportunity to find out what's on farmers' minds. I mean, actually being able to have so many people from different parts of the UK in one place, all talking about things that matter to them. At the moment, obviously, Brexit is the unavoidable question, but it's thrown up all sorts of insights into what it actually means, what it's going to mean in the short term, longer term.
To see Minette Batters really getting visibly passionate, even angry at times, made me realise that it's getting to the crunch point with Brexit now.
I think from the Labour Party, what David Drew as Shadow Minister was saying, that you know they would commit to a budget long term, so they would be looking to a multi-annual budget being on the face of the bill. He also made an important commitment on food standards of welfare, environment and food safety. Those are sort of key amendments that we have been asking for, and it's very helpful to have the Labour Party commit to that. Michael Gove again talked about it, but at the moment it's still slightly in the warm word territory. He isn't talking about putting it on the face of the bill, but he is acknowledging that actually they need to do more, and we would be happy on the standards if they committed to a black and white policy statement bringing a UK-wide group together to agree what the future should look like on standards.